Hey everyone, we have it now, the official unveiling of the 2022 holiday set from LEGO, the Winter Village set this is. This was called Holiday Main Street or Christmas High Street, depending upon what region you're in, and it will be available to purchase on October the 3rd, as long as you have a VIP account, which anybody can have a VIP account on LEGO. If you don't happen to have a VIP account, then it's October the 7th, $100 US. It's checking my sources over here. Yes, 100 euros as well, or 90 pounds UK, 130 Canadian dollars for 1,514 pieces. 1,514 pieces. They don't have the part count right here. For some reason, it's somewhere down here. But let's take a look at this. See what it's like. It's very different from recent years, that's for sure. And it comes with a Mr. Rogers style cable car or trolley or tram, again, depending upon what region you're from. I guess whether it's a cable car depends on whether it's actually cable powered. Anyway, where I'm from, the things that look like this are typically cable cars. Comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 minifigures and 2 stores. Of course, there's a Christmas tree there. The box definitely could have been cheerier. The black background thing doesn't do any justice, that's for sure, to the more fun and whimsical themes. Why did they put this on some reclaimed tarred lumber? That doesn't do it any justice either. Okay, this is a little bit better here. I want to see the buildings a little bit better. I guess this is probably the best picture that they've got right now. We can zoom in and take a better look. So this over here is a music store, and it just has an apartment up top. So it looks like the size here is the old standard, roughly 8x16. You know, like they've done a number of city buildings in the past. And you got the music store with a very small drum set here. Has the white guitar from Mickey Mouse and violin as well. A little cash register and a saxophone. All right, so drumsticks here, cool. Printed keyboard there. That's probably gonna be a sticker. Wish I could see what it actually is. And then upstairs, just the apartment with a little kitchenette. Mini kitchenette, what do you call that? Kitchenette-ette. Sand blue color for the cabinets there and sand blue color for the chairs. The other place is a little toy store. And once again, down below, you've got the store itself. So I can't quite see on the other side. I'm going to need some better views of this. Let's see. Does this show it? This shows the upper floor. I want to see the lower floor better. I want to see the store itself. You see a little bit better at the front? Not so much. I think that's supposed to be a train. Yeah, that's a train at the front. Classic Lego train at the front. Steam train. And then is there anything else? Is there like is that a toy Christmas tree in between there? I can't quite tell what that actually is, but there's a robot in front of it. And then you can also buy some roller skates. Now we can look upstairs. So this is just the one that we look at. Minecraft? Really? They took a Minecraft printed tile and put it in there for the backsplash? Okay. I'll take a print, a decent print, sure. But this is the upstairs room with a small Christmas tree and some gifts around it. And it's the kids' room over on the toy shop side of things. This is definitely something that we've needed a lot from LEGO. And it looks like in its default form, it actually will hold some people. It also has the ability to be powered up, as you can see, by putting in the powered up hub unit and then a powered up train base and lights as well. That's good. I want to see more of the tram, trolley, cable car thing. Yeah, this. So here you can see that it's able to hold 2 minifigures on either side. That's a total of 4. But you can also put more on the inside. Maybe 4 more. Maybe a total of 8. I think at least 6, that's for sure. It should be able to sit in there. Yeah. So that's very respectable, but the ability to power it up is nice. Now, powered up stuff is not included here. Track is not included either. The side build is that. This is pretty decent. This is nice with the clock and the Main Street, you know, throwback to Main Street set. Don't think I've seen that face there before. Let's take a look at the mini. Do they have a better picture of just the minifigures? Do they not? Not so good with these pictures on the site, huh? I want to see the alternate face for that head. Oh, that's the alternate face right there. Just a big smiling. Maybe I have seen this one before. Don't recognize it personally. Okay. I wish that we got more better. That's that one. Good. I wish we got more better pictures from this. Let's see what this looks like. This is just the 360. This will really show you, yep, the size of these buildings here, which is six. This is only six studs deep. The main part of the building itself, the main structure. Not eight. Same thing here. Six studs only. And then you get a little bit of extension in front of that. Ah, they're so shallow. So shallow, unfortunately. But what I really want to look at, though, look at this video. Yeah. Spice it up a little bit. No. Take all this dark and tar away. The parts are in that bowl, candy bowl. Yeah, this is festive. This is a nice little scene. It's not in a bunker, you know. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, a kid actually playing with the toy. Good. I haven't talked about the Christmas tree. I guess because it's not too different. That's nice. See? Yes. That is... Leave it to a kid to play with a toy, even though he was probably instructed to. Like, that's right. Most people who get this are not going to have a huge city layout with multiple loops of track and everything. They're going to play with it exactly like that. So that's what I like to see. Good. All right. Well presented. Well, I guess that's about it. All there is to talk about other than the Christmas tree, which, you know, we've had almost this exact same build before. This exact same build strategy used. I think there are some wedge plates that didn't exist the last time around. And then this is also using an astromech head for a portion of it. Does not light up, but overall, this looks pretty good to me. Yeah, it looks very good to me, actually. The price of $100 US, again, it's over 1,500 pieces, so the price-to-part ratio is unbelievably good, but it does have a ton of just one-by-one pieces, one-by-one, tiles and little foliage pieces and flowers and things. Oh, dark blue for these small... and also the silver candlesticks over here. Dark blue for the small window frames, dark green for the small window frames over here. That's good. Volume of stuff, probably not great, especially with how thin those buildings are, but at least it's a nice festive scene. It's pretty proper. And I think that for most folks, this will display well. But compared to a lot of the other stuff that we've gotten from LEGO, the structures don't have much depth. So there are definitely going to be things that you're going to want to place in the background of your scene if you're continuing to develop a scene over time. I will be buying this, and I will be building it over live on my Twitch channel, and I will review it for sure over on my LEGO Reviews channel. Links to both of those in the video description. Be sure to be following those if you want to see everything that I do. And I'll talk to you again soon. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.